Hello, I'm Farah Larieux, and welcome to Haiti Journal. Haiti Journal is a monthly public affairs program covering current issues facing the Haitian American community in the U.S. and abroad, produced in partnership between WPBT2 and the Haitian American Professionals Coalition. The Haitian Constitution states that Haiti has two official languages, French and Creole. Despite the fact that Creole is the language spoken and understood by all Haitians, the language of instruction and official documents remains French. Should Haiti have one official language? To answer that question and much more, we invited Georges Bossou, founder and executive director of Word and Action, Inc., Rony Joseph, project director of Educational Opportunity Center at Miami-Dade College, and Evelyn Cartwright, assistant professor of English and director of African Studies at Berry University. Thank you all for being here today. So, pleasure. This is a question, and I will start with the lady. Should Haiti have one official language?
Definitely, yes. It should only one language, and I believe that French should be taught as a second language.
Okay, and I will go with you, Georges.
Well, I would say that Haiti should have two official languages because both languages are part of our culture.
And our history, you will say?
Our history, too? Absolutely. Because if you look at our Act of Independence, it's written in French, and a lot of generals, those who've been in history, has been speaking in French. So our literature, part of our literature was in French. So I think that both languages are core part of our who we are as people.
And you, Wani.
I support the constitution, the two languages. I believe that was a good happening. Two languages, official two languages, Haitian.
Okay. The Creole and the French.
And French.
But some state quote, Haiti is a linguist apartheid. Those who spoke only Creole are often treated as a second-class citizen. So what do you think about it?
Definitely they are. And we see this. Haitians feel that there is this elite. And when we look at the population, only less than 10% of Haitians speak French fluently. So we're leaving this entire population out by sticking to me, it's the colonial language. Like we're hanging on to this. And I think it's time that we agree that to properly educate that population, we need to do it in Creole. And once they have mastered all the different steps that they need to, all the different disciplines, then we can start teaching them French as a second language.
Okay.
But the official language should be Creole so that everybody is included and feel included.
And Winnie?
We do not have a language problem in Haiti. The problem is social, political, and economic. We have two Haiti. We have the cities, we have the
country.
Rural Haiti, we have a French Haiti and a Creole, Haitian Creole speaking Haiti. We have the Christian religion and we have the Vundu. What we need to address are those issues to become one nation. 100% of Haitians speak Haitian Creole. So it's not a language problem.
But how do you propose to educate that population? And I look at this as an educator. We need to be student-centered. We need to take care of the student. And to do so, teaching the students to learn material in French and memorizing them, what are we teaching, really?
I think the problem is more into our educational system. I don't think the language is a problem. Language is just a vehicle. Language is just a means of communication. If we have better teachers, if the educational system is stronger, if you look at the former generations who were educated in French, I was educated in French, and I learned Creole as well. But if you look at the former generation to the current generation, now they are coming up with French and Creole, for example, the L'École Fondamentale, you would see the big disparity between the two. So I think that instead of the language debate, is more into the educational system that needs to be changed. I think that the problem stands more with the using of language as a means to intimidate somebody. But I think that if we equip our teachers and our students properly, language shouldn't be having a problem.
We'll go deeper on the education system, our challenges, but going back to the challenge as Haitian, 100% Haitian speak Creole, but like you said, Evelyn, 10% of the population speak French. And we see that people tend to say that Creole is a dialect. And do you think that Creole is a dialect?
No, it's a full language. It is a language. And I think by a lot of people saying that or hanging to that, that's why they're disparaging Creole. There is no reason why we should not recognize, and it is recognized as a language, has its own phonetic system, its own grammar. Mm-hmm. Okay? And other countries like Finland, Denmark, Iceland, they have smaller population than Haiti, and they do have their own language, and they don't give it up to be global. And they teach their children English, like the other languages, so that they can interact with the rest of the world. So Haiti needs to do that, to do recognize that Creole is the language and decide, okay, we're going to teach French as well, but French should be the other, the second language that we teach our children in school.
I agree when it comes to recognizing Creole. I'm not against Creole. I recognize Creole is a language. It's a language of my mother. This is my mother's tongue. I don't have a problem with that. Okay. My thing here is I'm more against the omission of the other part of our culture, because you cannot discard the French language, even if it's colonial. It is brought by colonialism. It's the same thing that English is brought by colonialism to Jamaica. In Switzerland, you have four languages. We don't have much problem with that. In Canada, we have two official languages. We don't have much problem with that. The problem is more into the education system. I would rather feel comfortable seeing every Haitian, all 100% Haitian, mastering both languages. It would be feeling comfortable.
We can do that, but we're not talking about discarding French. We have a problem. The problem is now, today, and we need to fix it. So how do we get that population educated? That population that doesn't speak French. And now what I learned is the teachers in the school system, they're not fluent in French.
And we will go back to this, but I want to hear Winnie's perspective as far as the geographic position of Haiti, where we are surrounded by Spanish and English spoken countries and islands. And what's your perspective about that?
Before addressing this, I would like to go back to the previous topic. When I say the Constitution admits two languages, when I say I support the Constitution, that doesn't mean French at the expense of Haitian Creole. All research shows that we need to start with the home language. Yes. I have no problem with that, and that's what we need to do. Yes. Teach the Haitian Creole, start there, and then transition into the other language, not start with the foreign language.
Yes.
Now, geographically.
Geographically, now we need to talk about four languages for Haiti, not just two. We need to talk about Haitian Creole, which is the national language of all Haitians, and we can do anything in Haitian Creole. We need to talk about the French. We need to talk about English, and now Spanish. If I were in Haiti having a school, I would push all three,
but
all four.
If English and Spanish are taught in Haiti, are taught in
Haiti.
Yes. I learned both. And they served me well when I came here to the States, whatever I learned in schools.
Just one moment, George. But you think, Wani, that we should increase that more than we do? Because in the education system, they taught They teach Creole and Spanish and English for 6 years. Mm-hmm. And that's why we Haitian are very adaptable to French, to English and Spanish, and moving to into the United States.
Not only encourage it, we should invest heavily in foreign languages so that each Haitian, educated Haitians from school should at least speak three.
I would agree.
And we should invest heavily.
Not at the expense of the other topics,
no,
though.
No, absolutely. I'm reiterating what I'm saying earlier. My argument is not against Creole. I learned Creole. I would portray in Creoles. I love Creole. It's a beautiful language. However, once we are putting all populations who are already segregated, prejudice against, and then now using that language, because there's a level of hypocrisy when it comes to that language problem in Haiti, because you've seen some people were saying, okay, we should educate ourselves in Creole, but some of us are kids in our household, we speak French, and it's a problem. I think that the problem is more into teaching both languages and then putting the great curriculum. We're changing the entire educational system because, listen, between 1 to 5, a child could, you know, absorb 4 or 5 languages.
And about the segregation, you want to add something?
Yes. You see, some of these children speak French at home. You are still catering to that 10%, or to that less than 10%. How do we continue to do that?
Then expand it. Don't make it 10%. Make it 90%.
And this is my next question about. Do you think that actually, some think that this Creole French challenge also divide the country, divide the nation? What you said.
Well, in some ways, it doesn't, I would not say divide, it does, but in some ways it's perpetuate these notions like the bourgeoisie, like these people, the haves and the have-nots, that separation, that less than 10% wants to keep it in place.
And are we coming to what Winnie mentioned at the beginning, talking about social issue?
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
It's no more a language issue. It becomes a social issue, yes. Right, Winnie?
Certainly.
Yes, certainly it does.
The language is used as a tool.
Yes.
And most, if not
and
all, members of the population who pretend to be francophone, they speak Creole at home. And they speak French when they meet you.
Oh, yeah.
On the street or in the office and so forth, which is changing though. Even that is becoming.
So the mentality
is becoming
the
past.
This is the problem.
If you don't speak my language, I may not do business with you. And you should watch the level of discourse in Haitian Creole all over the country at all levels. I'm pleased to see the exchanges at the parliament, the officials, they use the language effectively and in all aspects, of life. So this is encouraging and this is important. So the problem is a socio-economical, political issues. So as long as, for instance, we have 90% in abject poverty, and you have 10 to 5% holding on the assets and the wealth of the country. So language will always be used as an exclusion tool. But it's not really a language problem in my view.
And I totally agree with them. I totally agree to that aspect. And this way I'm talking about education, because the mentality, our prejudice, or colorism, if I would put it that way. This is what needs to be changed, because we use that language as a tool to exclude people. But I want to use the same language to include them, because I want them to be able to speak both languages. I want them, when you are speaking with them in French and try to lie to them and try to make them feel uncomfortable, they can respond back to you. And this is my challenge. I don't want it to be just because you're still going to have that. Imagine you put Creole at 100%, you're still going to have that 10% holding on that French.
Okay. Listen.
Just one moment. Everything you say makes a lot of sense. The only thing that I am fighting for is that we take the 90% these children go to school, have no knowledge of French whatsoever, yes. And you hand them these French books. This is an handicap. We start teaching them from the tongue that they learn, that they know. We educate them in all these other subjects. Then we teach them French. We do not leave them halfway.
But what we can do also, we can at very early age.
And they will be able to.
And I think at very early age, you could give them both. You can give them both languages at a very early age.
Yes, but don't hand them all these French books.
I agree.
Let's go back to a couple years where, and this is a very important moment in the history of education system in Haiti, which is the Bernard Reform. And the Bernard Reform started in the late 70s, where the Minister of Education, Mr. Bernard, he launched the new education system. You remember that?
Yes.
Okay. Then one of the goals of this reform was actually exactly the use of Creole, the mother tongue of the student, as language of instruction for basic education to facilitate the learning and to achieve a bilingual system. That was the goal. Now, do you think that, based on what you just said, is the Bernard Reform shows progress or not?
Good question.
This is why we have Haitian Creole as an official language. And this is what Félix Maurice Auloi, since early 60s, has been fighting for. And in 1979, finally, there was a law that instructed the Minister of Education to publish a standardized spelling. In 1980, Minister Bernard did that. 1987, finally, the Haitian Creole became an official language in our constitution. So that's a result of this effort, the fruition of all that effort. And now it's being taught in school. Now an official person in official capacity doesn't have to speak French. To go back to what you said, we need to teach Haitian French so that they can respond when they talk to them in French. Why should I answer you in French when the language we both understand and speak best is Haitian Creole? This is not my purpose for French. My purpose for French is to allow me to delve into the resources, thousands of years available in French, so that I can enhance my education, my information sources, and so forth. But you, we can speak in French. It's nice. But if all Haitians don't need French to communicate, they at don't. All levels. So when one is using French when presenting or interacting with another group, it's not a language problem. This person is trying to exclude this group, not to get access to certain things.
I agree. And this is where I would rather the entire population, again, I'm going to reiterate what I said earlier, being able to use both languages. Because as you said earlier, the problem is education, is social class, is all those socioeconomic problems, which I agree with it. Now, even if you have the 100% Haitian speaking Creole, look what was happening. I remember Jacques-Séphé and Alexis. There was no Haitian that could say this more Haitian than Jacques-Séphé and Alexis, a great intellectual. He agreed and said, you know what? I feel that I have some French culture in me. In other words, the problem, again, doesn't reside in the language. The problem is the use of the language when we use that language as a means of exclusion rather than inclusion. So if we teach our kids our both angle of our culture, Creole and French, and without any prejudice, we won't have that much problem. What about the other countries with four languages?
That's the constitution.
What about the other countries?
You're repeating the constitution.
There is something else too. Okay. That using that language as a tool or as a weapon will not even become an issue at all if we turn around and say, from now on, the official language is Creole. From now on, our children are going to be taught in Creole. If we have all of that in place, somebody turning around and using French as a tool is going to look ridiculous.
Now, let's
it's not going to be as effective.
Let's shift the conversation a little bit on the social issue and political issue. Because we all agree on the fact that language is a communication tool, and we all agree that 100% Haitians speak Haitian Creole. So why not, after 1996, it become official that Haiti has two languages? We don't see much more investment on an Academy of Creole and on expanding the education system in Creole, so everybody can have the same opportunity to education opportunity.
My question is, are we trying to expand and promoting a language, or are we trying to promote education? Because the problem resides in education. The educational system is not working properly. Even if we make quite a bit of progress in the emancipation or in the strengthening of the language, but education-wise, we are not making that progress.
I'm answering your question. We haven't seen much progress in that because, again, the less than 10%, they are in charge. The less than 10%, they want to keep
French?
The status quo.
Yes.
Okay. That's the social issue. Mm-hmm. That has always been. That population that do not speak French, that less than 10% does not want to see that population succeed or do better or bring them up to their level. There is this barrier that they mean to keep in place. So that's the huge social issue that you talked about. That should be addressed.
And I agree with you.
That should be broken down.
And
these barriers have to come down.
I agree with you. But
let's have Wani add something.
The country has a serious problem of resources. We all agree on that. And that's fact. Mm-hmm. Now, it's a matter of choice and how much we're going to invest in education of the resources we have. So, and this is an imperative because that's a constitutional mandate. Everything now should be available in Haitian Creole. It's not being done because of lack of resources. So this is why I believe using Haitian Creole right away and head on without using the French as a language of instruction, I don't believe that's the way to proceed. Because by the time to have everything available in Haitian Creole for the schools, we lose two generations. So we need to invest heavily in education and supporting the Haitian Creole, development of materials, making the official documents available in Haitian Creole, according to the Constitution, that's an official language, and that's the way to go.
You talk several times, investing heavily into education system. In 2011, President Joseph Michel Martelly said that he will increase the number of children who will have access to education. Mm-hmm. Is that enough?
There is a big difference, in my opinion, between building schools or take a group of kids, put them in a school, or changing the educational system. Mm-hmm. Okay, there's a huge difference. Because what I think the investment should be is to first investing the educational system so we could have more human resources. 80% of our human resources are abroad, and it's been a challenge. So I think that we should invest more in recalibrate our educational system, making a Haitian educational system, building Haitians for Haitian progress, then you're going to see a big change when it comes to the growth of the country.
Okay. If we're waiting to have resources to do anything, nothing will be done. Education needs to become a priority. Okay. And then we do need to take baby steps to make the changes that are necessary. Michelle DeGraff, an educator here in Boston? Yes, he went to Haiti, mm-hmm. and he kind of did a pilot study with the one private Catholic school, and it was successful. Like he took some teachers and did a workshop to teach, to show them how to do this, like teach in Creole, like, and it was successful. So we can look to models like this one and see what did he use
and
how to do it.
And Woni, last word?
The answer to your question, I don't have enough information to answer this question. I know that the president, the government, has made education a top priority, but I don't have the facts. How many the budget of the Department of Education, are invested per pupil? I don't have this information.
Unfortunately, we are out of time. For more information about our program, please visit our website at wpbt2.org/HaitiJournal. Thank you, everyone. We will return next month with, actually next year, 2014, with another edition of Haiti Journal on Sunday, January 12, and on Sunday, January 26 at 12:30 p.m. right here on WPBT2. I'm Fala Oyo. Thanks for watching. Thank you, everyone.